Hey guys. Ooh. Lazy Sunday. Let me get my game switched over. There you go. If you have epilepsy, stop watching now. Let me just get chat up on my phone and we'll be ready to rock. So I played this game for about 10 minutes, expecting it to be garbage. It just came in one of the humble bundles. I don't even know which one. And I was pretty impressed. So I figured I'd bring it up on Twitch and stream it. Because it looks pretty damn good. Let me just make sure my chat here is working. So this is a text-based retro indie horror game. So I'm probably going to be reading a lot. So if you're not into that, then you probably won't enjoy this. We're all juiced up and ready to go. So we're playing The House Abandoned. You pull up to the driveway of the family holiday home and park your car. It's dark, but it's as idyllic as you remember from all that time ago. You remember being told to look in the glove box before going in. It's good to be back. So let's look in the glove box. Closed. Okay. This is like nostalgia. So hard. A handwritten note from Dad and a key. Key to the house. The note is from your dad and reads, "Hey son, hope you enjoy your break. You'll first need to fire up the generator around back to get power and lights on. Also found something in the attic for you. It's in your room. Enjoy." Okay. So we probably want lights on before we go into the house. Let's get out of the car. The house is grand, set perfectly amongst the trees. In front of you is the front door, and the yard stretches around to the side of the house. Take a walk around the yard. The yard has been well maintained. You spent a lot of time here with your family on holiday trips. Good memories. We look around and see a generator on the back wall of the house. The generator's fuel gauge is healthy and it's manually operated. Alright, let's turn it on. You switch the generator on and it whirs to life. The house is still dark. Let's go back to the front. You walk back around to the front of the house. Unlock the door. And go inside. You step inside the front door. You enter the house to the hallway. It's dark, you can't see anything, but you feel a light switch next to the door. Let's turn on the lights. You flick the switch and the lights come on. The hallway is now brightly lit. There's access to the kitchen and living room here, as well as a set of stairs going up. You walk into the kitchen. Kitchen is tidy and well kept. There's a door to a utility room, but otherwise it's just a kitchen. Nothing special. Utility room door is locked. You have no idea where the key could be. And it doesn't understand. Unlock utility room. Okay. Let's, what was the other room? We go back out to the hallway. You step inside the living room. A spacious and comfortable living room. We spent a lot of good time here playing board games with the family. Warm and inviting. Thing of interest. Let's go upstairs. You walk upstairs to the landing. Stairwell landing, there's a bathroom and two bedrooms, yours and your sister's. Pictures adorn the walls, images of happy times. Family photos and holiday snaps. Our happy family. You walk into your sister's old room. It's in perfect condition, untouched since the last time you've seen her. Posters of her heroes and some of her own attempts at art adorn the walls. A few shelves are crammed full of trophies. Her bed is drowned under a pile of colorful soft toys. A real nostalgia trip. There's a large wardrobe in the corner of the room. The door is slightly ajar. A large clothes wardrobe. Unusually, the door is slightly ajar. She never liked you going through her stuff. Go through her stuff. Alright, let's go back onto the landing. Step into the bathroom. You're in the bathroom. There's not much to note, but it's all in good order. Clean, a large mirror sitting above the sink. Alright, we walk into our old room. Your old bedroom, so many good memories here, and it's been preserved so well. On the desk is a gift-wrapped box. Standard bedroom, desk, wood grain TV, the usual. Let's open the gift. You unwrap the gift excitedly. You can't believe it. Dad has found your old computer, a Futura 128K Plus 2. It's been preserved well in the attic, and hopefully it still works. On your desk is a Futura 128K Plus 2 computer and a copy of The House Abandoned. It's all still set, has to be set up, though. You start to plug in the various cables and leads. The computer's all set up and ready to go. There's a game here, too. It's a new horror game called The House Abandoned. Looks ace. You put the cassette into the computer and press play. Told to check the glove box before going in. You can't stand to be near this place. It's dark, but it's clearly neglected. Inside is a glove box and a handwritten note from Dad. Did I say inside is a glove box? Inside is a key. You don't recognize the handwriting. It says, "Get out, get out, get out. Get out of the car, get out of the car." Key to the house. You force the warped car door open and fall out. The house looks abandoned. There's a yard to the side, wood creaks in the wind. And all happy memories are gone from this place. There is no love here. You step through the debris to the backyard. The grass is overgrown. Weeds crawl up the side of the house. It's not a nice place to be. You clutch the note, needing to look around. There's an old generator next to you. The old generator could supply power to the house. There isn't much fuel, but the generator starts up. Oh, it's so good. You go back to the front of the house. It's so meta. I'm playing the game that I'm playing. That I'm playing. That I'm playing. I'm playing. You unlock the door. The click of the lock hurts to hear. You reluctantly step inside the front door. Pitch black, but your senses are punished more by the smell. Stale and damp. This could not be less inviting. The note burns in your hands. You feel compelled to read it over and over. It's too dark to read, but it feels weird to the touch. Afraid of what you might see, you flick on the light switch. Lights flicker on and off. The walls are falling apart after years of neglect or worse. Upstairs, the sound of an alarm clock blaring. Someone else is in the house. This can't be. Someone is in the house. They should not be here. There's a kitchen and a living room adjacent and a stairs leading up. The note feels disgusting in your hands. You can't read the note. It's bleeding. You head up the stairs. They creak. Same, but different. The landing has access to your sister's room. Your room and the bathroom. Jesus fucking Christ. Behind the door, a phone starts to ring. You don't understand. Neither can he. You hear him answer the phone. Your mind hurts and you taste iron. Voices spill out of the phone into the room. Whoever is in there should not be there. You need to hang up the phone. I do. Whoever. You consider the worst. Relief. Pictures are all over the wall, but something is different about them. Pictures are of your family. The eyes have been scored out on all. Oh my god, and they're actually scored out on the desk here. I'm getting creeped out. And now it's 99.99 o'clock. Jennifer's room is boarded up. You can't bear this. You enter the bathroom. It feels disgusting. Every surface is covered in a layer of oily grime. The sink is a haven for all kinds of bugs. A broken mirror hangs above a dirty sink, taps rusted in position. The door is bolted shut with a four-digit combination lock. Barren, worn. Photos adorn the wall, all misaligned. Go back downstairs. This reminds me of playing MUDs, but I'm scared. In MUDs, I was scared of getting killed by a kobold. In this game, I'm just plain scared. The kitchen stinks and feels completely unfamiliar. The tabletops are rusted metal and there's a carcass on the table. There's writing on the wall, and the utility room door has a red X painted on it. Carcass. You can't tell what it is or what it was. There's a red X on the door. You assume it's paint. Yeah, it must be paint. Feels like the note. Door's locked. I can't get in there. Not yet. Step back into the hallway. Your shoes are wet. the living room, although hardly an appropriate term. The furniture is threadbare and worn. The note is fixed in your mind. Dread fills the pit of your stomach. This is not a nice place. Run down and empty, abandoned, for good reason. The note is now clean again, simply reading, "Get in, get out." Gotta be a way to enter a code. You grab the lock. The lock is rusted, not used in years. The key in your hand weighs heavy, the note heavier. You grab the lock and can now input the code. A working 4-digit code, you know it's in the house somewhere. You let go of the lock. Alright, now we just need to find the code. The note appears to change or guard depending on where we read it. Let's try reading in different rooms. Note is impossible to read due to the black oil now covering it. I wish I could type while I was doing this. Why does it say sisters like that? The note because it's bleeding. writing on the wall and what looks to be blood. Blood, the number 1986, is smeared across the wall. Okay. Clicks open. Same but different. The door is closed. Open the bedroom door. You enter your bedroom. Feels utterly familiar. The walls are damp, but you've been here before. In front of you, a lone person sits in front of a computer screen. A lamp is on. The clock reads 99.99. You shouldn't be here. I shouldn't be here. You grip the note tight. I'm sorry, Jennifer. I'm sorry, Mom. I'm sorry, Dad. You haunt every step I take, even in this place. It was out of my hands, but still you punish me. I can be with you now. There's nothing left to do. I'm consumed and confused. This has to end now. You are pathetic. It was all your fault. Say it. I don't believe you like you mean it, please. It was all my fault, say it. That was pretty good. There's four more little stories. Untold stories. Should we keep going? I don't know. Maybe these are more fun to just play than to stream. Let's go. The lab conduct. I love this retro intro. It's so good.
This is subject. 12/19/86/23, new session entry. We have myself, Dr. Alexander, leading, assisted by Dr. Williams, and in the lab itself, our volunteer, Mr. Asian. We have artifact 23 in the chamber, recovered from crash site B. At the moment, it appears inert, showing no signs of activity. Mr. Asian, instructions for each stage will come through to your terminal, and we need you to follow them exactly. Now, some of this may be unfamiliar, so always reference the manual on your terminal for guides on calibration and procedure. Once you've calibrated equipment to match our brief, the green light will flash, allowing you to trigger the experiment. One last thing. Ensure that any equipment non-essential to the current experiment is switched off. You cannot proceed until your calibration matches ours. When you're ready, let's bring this back.
Jeez, this is weird. This reminds me of, like, the Dharma Initiative from Lost kind of stuff. I don't think we're gonna stream this, though. I think we're gonna go ahead and stop here. Thanks, guys.